Woohoo! Miss Fisher and the Crypt of Tears is an Australian film that follows Phryne Fisher as she solves one of her greatest mysteries yet. Accompanied by her seemingly disapproving love interest, Detective Inspector Jack Robinson, the pair embark on a journey to stop an impending curse with roots tied to World War I. Having been a fan of this television series when I was younger, I was very excited to see this movie. The first scene broke the cinema chat with a chase scene set in 1929 Palestine as the titular character posed for what should have been a very dramatic title opening sequence. But unfortunately, that is actually where the movie starts to crumble. The title itself resembled a 90s movie that went straight to VHS and ended up in the sales rack. It's really hard to recover from poor first impressions, and unfortunately they didn't. What followed was just a really stretched out television episode. As a fan who watched the series some years ago, the reunion was very disappointing. It's something that anyone outside of the fandom isn't going to understand. I don't see how anyone who doesn't follow Miss Fisher can really enjoy this movie. On the other hand, this movie was partially crowdfunded and really was made for the fans who were invited to come on set and be extras. Even still, I was a fan of this series once, but I found that moving the characters from the television screen to the silver screen made them quite bland. Essie Davis, who plays Miss Fisher, has even said that the movie needed to be a rampant, crazy adventure full of titillation, stupidity, and naughtiness. And it is full of that stuff, but not in an endearing way. Unfortunately, that is also my sentiment towards the visual effects and cinematography. The visual effects were something that you would expect from a television series, not a 2-hour film. And the cinematography really drove home the importance of sticking to a cinematic theme. If it's noir and mystery that the director is after, then the shots need to resemble that. Murder mysteries really need to play that fine line of babying its audiences with clues, as well as leading them to plausible but incorrect answers. The visuals in this movie did neither, and it led to the story relying heavily on exposition from the main characters. Miss Fisher and the Crypt of Tears is unfortunately a film I would not enjoy beyond a rainy day while finishing a puzzle. Fans might be thrilled with the Indiana Jones efforts and their high-flying heroine, but with its poor TV to movie transition, VHS visual effects, as well as poor cinematography, I do not see this movie doing well with the general public. So, unfortunately, this movie gets a 5.5 out of 10 from me. On top of this movie being based on a television series, it's also based on a book series. I'm hoping there are a few of you out there who have read it because I want to get your recommendation. Should I start reading it? Because I really should start reading more. Pop your thoughts in the comments down below. And as always, thank you so much for watching. My name is Brittany and you have been watching Brit Girl. This is a little bit spoilery, but there is a cliche that everyone throws about when playing things like Cluedo. This movie falls into the trap. It's not the candlestick. It's not the kitchen. It's the whodunit. I don't see this succeeding with the general public. Naruto!